What's your name? Never mind, we'll come tomorrow. It's just a waste of time. I don't love.
I was like wondering about how you got your start. I know you kind of like lived in the South for a while, mm-hmm. and then moved north to Baltimore. How did you hook up with these guys and start as a band?
When I moved to Baltimore, I was playing with some guys, and then pretty quickly after we got there, we quit. We just weren't feeling Baltimore. And Billy and Steve were living in Baltimore and playing in other bands. They were, while we were still playing and together in Baltimore, they were in a few of the bands that we actually played with. So once I knew that those guys were, my old bandmates were going to leave, mm-hmm. I swooped in and snagged these guys. Yeah.
Were you all playing like the same kind of music you're doing now, or did you come from like different backgrounds?
So we're generally doing maybe not quite as southern inflected, but we're all playing rock, yeah. I guess.
What's the rock scene like out on the East Coast?
The East Coast?
Yeah.
So how much there's a rock scene, really?
Yeah,
there's not.
There's not a rock scene anywhere.
I don't know if there's much of a rock scene anywhere.
Yeah. Just kind of a change. Like, you guys did a residency up in Philly at North Star Bar, right?
Mm-hmm.
How did that go?
It was
cool.
Yeah, we did three residencies sort of all together. So we did one in D.C., Philly, and New York, and it was really great. I mean, I think that, you know, all three cities. The first couple shows, you know, we had some fans already, so they were there and kind of, I guess you could say, knew what to do. But it took the first two shows, probably in each town, for there really to be this thing happen where it kind of clicks, and then all of a sudden the third show, people are, instead of just standing there going, I don't know what to do, are like getting involved and having a good time.
Yeah, so you kind of like got a following from that.
Yeah.
Would you say? One of my friends was telling me that he played North Star Bar once, and that the stage is like really high and really kind of scary. He's like, ask him if they were like ever afraid they're gonna be rocking out and fall off or something.
Yeah, a little bit.
Like, well, they don't have monitors.
The monitors are off the stage up, so you can literally like step off the stage if you're not careful.
Normally it feels like there's a wall kind of, the monitors are, you know, 2 or 3 feet deep, and they're at the edge of the stage. And I think in an effort to get a little more stage room, they mounted the monitors to the balcony.
Yeah.
So it just, it feels like, it feels kind of dank. The first time we were standing up getting ready to play, this definitely feels like an accident waiting to happen.
So you guys have been on tour for like, I don't know, it seems like a while. How long have you been on tour exactly?
This go around?
This tour or?
Yeah, this
well,
actually
just in general,
like,
have you taken a break somewhere in between since like your record came out?
You have to take breaks. I mean, there have been times that we've gone really long chunks of time and you lose all touch of with reality and humanity, and like you just kind of you turn into like this weird pseudo animal where you're just kind of like no hormones seep into your brain. But we've been touring a lot for about 4 years, 4.5 years.
Do you have any favorite venues that you've been?
This is definitely one of my favorites. Yeah.
Mine too. I love this place.
Southgate is, I was just telling the guy that owns a guitar store here in Cincinnati that Southgate's one of my favorite venues for sure.
Yeah, I'm trying to think of other ones that I like.
40 Watt.
Yeah, 40 Watt in Athens is really awesome.
I thought the Troubadour was really cool.
Yeah, the Troubadour in LA was great.
I mean, generally there's no mediocre club. Like, it's either really awful or pretty awesome. Trying to think of anything, right? And every once in a while you play a place that's just kind of ho-hum, whatever, but normally it's, and then sometimes it goes over that level of being so crappy that it actually is awesome again.
Yeah. do you have any memorable moments from like crowd interaction or just like, I felt like I was super on this night, it was like the best night of my life or something?
We played a show here actually for the Cincy Punk Fest in this room. I think this is one of the things about something about where it gets so crappy that it goes back to being awesome. It's like the sound is really bad, and there was, you know, it was packed from shoulder to shoulder, and there was some about three quarters of the way back and was throwing empty beer cans up in the ceiling fan. And they were ricocheting off, and they hit Billy, and they were hitting the back wall like they're playing. There's been this dull thud, like when there's like half filled beer, like dented in on the side.
It was a really awesome show.
There's some rowdy photos from that one.
Yeah.
Yeah, it was like 200 degrees.
Beer spraying everywhere.
Yeah.
Looked like there was just like, yeah, just a freaking beer.
It's amazing. I've never been to Slugfest.
It was gnarly. I don't know.
I don't know if they still have it.
Maybe they did. They have it this year, but
okay.
I didn't.
Well, it's great. We had a blast.
That's awesome.
I think that was going to maybe the only show. If there was a second one, there's only two. Or actually ended up on Billy's shoulders while he was playing guitar solo.
Yeah.
And I climbed over the piano and I
forgot about that.
He didn't know what I was doing, but.
They did that in Oxford once, and then every time he came back for the next year, all the papers talked about the time he did a backflip off the piano, which never actually happened. It made its way into local legend.
That's
and
awesome.
It always got billed as, you know, J. Roddy did do those backflips off
the
piano. I think you actually did flip over the piano once.
Not in Oxford, but. For some reason, Oxford took that.
So. Might have been accidental.
Yeah.
Tell me that's on YouTube. That would be amazing.
No, I wish it was. No, I think there was like, I was going to try to jump over the piano, and I was too hyped up. I was really red, and I went to jump, and my hand, like, kind of was just going to hurtle over it, and instead, my feet just went over my head. And I just, like, landed on my back. And it was the end of the set anyway, so I just kind of laid there, like, oh, I can't believe I just did that.
In New York, you didn't move. Like, you laid on your back, and I just lay there. And
yeah.
Just did
You talked about how like there's not really a rock scene anymore so much. Do you feel like rock could go mainstream again? And especially not like necessarily modern rock that you hear on the radio now, but like southern rock or blues rock. Do you think that has potential, or do you think that's even a good idea?
Well,
I don't know. I mean, I don't know if we sit around considering it too much.
Yeah.
I feel like it's kind of prime. It's like it was in the late 80s when Nirvana came along, like where it's just the radio is filled with like manufactured crap. I feel like there's a growing tide of resentment where people don't want it. I hope there's too much of resentment. I feel like it might be prime for like, I don't know. People don't want something real again.
That's something I've heard from a lot of people actually. I've talked to a few bands lately and they've all said that.
I think everybody's crossing their fingers.
Yeah.
I don't know. I mean, the whole mainstream success thing is such a weird, nebulous idea and kind of a dangerous proposition. You have one single and then you become a one-hit wonder or whatever. Yeah, or just like, people don't know that you've been grinding it out forever and just kind of. Take it for granted that you're here today and gone tomorrow.
Yeah. So that's not you'd say that's not necessarily something that you want to shoot for.
Not really. I mean, I think there are bands that are really good that can sort of rise to the occasion and they have one good single, but then it turns out they also have an album full of really good songs. And like, you know, that can work out for them. But yeah, definitely it's not an effort that we're making.
What's your, I don't want to say what's your goal, because that's not what I mean, but like, what do you hope that your band will be able to accomplish, or do you just have a personal, I want to write this kind of music, and...
I don't know, I think we all just want to creatively be as good as we can, and then...
As many people find out
about this possible. Yeah. I mean, we're definitely not saying we don't want to be successful.
Right, yeah. No.
We're game for that, for sure. I'm happy with the way things, like, there are times where inevitably you kind of, like, think that you can't pay your bills or something, you get kind of down on it, but as far as like how the last 2 years have gone, I'm pretty pumped on the way things are moving on. Yeah.
I just saw that you were mentioning Rolling Stone for one of the must-see acts of Monterey.
Yeah.
Are you playing that tomorrow?
Saturday.
Have you played Monterey before? No? This is the first time?
Yeah.
That's awesome.
Yeah.
do the festival circuit much?
This year's the first year.
First time.
Yeah.
Really?
We're doing a lot of them. We're doing Bonnaroo, All Good, Lollapalooza, Austin City Limits. We're doing the Bowski Fest down in Louisville.
Some smaller ones.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Hot August Blues.
Yeah, there's some stuff in Maryland.
Have you done South By?
Yeah, quite a bit. I think we have done all of South By at this point. We have exhausted that.
Every single
that world, yeah.
Yeah. That's what I hear. It's like super exhausting for bands, but
yeah, it's intense.
Yeah. Yeah.
Sure.